Aigagalefili Fepulea'i, Tapua'I first appeared on Breakfast in August. The Aorere College head girl described students at lower decile schools struggling to balance work and study during a pandemic as they took jobs to support their families affected by COVID-19. That's great love, but it's also great weight. She picked up the same theme in a question to Jacinda Ardern and Judith Collins in the First Leaders debate. She is a brilliant young woman. And people are saying they hear her, but people saying they hear you and acting because they've heard you aren't always the same thing. So, as we near exam season, do vulnerable students feel more supported now? Has anything changed, really? Aigagalefili, it's so good to have you in here. Welcome to the studio. Talofa lava, tēnā koe. Welcome. Tell me about the response to you. So I think people were stopped in their tracks by your eloquence, but also by the sense that they hadn't appreciated the unlevel playing field. Mm. So people say, I hear you, we must do something about it. Mm. But is the something about it being done?
I definitely don't think that there's enough being done in the sense that people have kind of sensationalised or romanticised the things that I've been saying. And I think that I'm definitely not a miracle, and there's definitely so many other students that are exactly like me, which is what I really tried to bring across. But over the course of the response to the media that I've been in, I think a lot of people have kind of not been open to hearing these other students' voices, and unfortunately that means they haven't been getting the support that they really need, especially from those in the highest positions of power. So yeah, it's been a really weird juxtaposition between people saying, you guys are so inspiring, but then not acting and not changing, like you said. So yeah, I definitely feel like that's been the case for a lot of our students, having to watch people respond in this way and then not seeing changes happen tangibly in their lives.
Did you describe this sort of being romanticised? So people say you're inspiring, wow, what extraordinary kids, and then step back as if having noticed you, nothing more is required. Mm. And yet, the obstacles you describe, and they're largely socioeconomic obstacles, still exist. And it means that students from families where times are really hard not only have tougher lives in terms of material deprivation, but in terms of their access to education, right?
Definitely.
And this is the point you want to make. Mm-hmm. And so what would you like to see happen?
I think there are so many different options and solutions that we could offer to our students. We could make scholarships for essential worker kids. Because I think that the really big difference between those who have worked in high school before and those who have worked in high school this year that people don't seem to be making is that students who are working and going to school this year, they were essential workers. They were essentially risking their lives, putting their own families at risk to make ends meet for their families. And so I think that that's a really stark difference between all the other people who've come through and worked throughout the years. Because as we've mentioned before, it's not a new problem, but COVID-19 has meant that the circumstances have changed drastically. And so I feel like for our students, we could do things like offering them scholarships for being essential workers. We could do things like making work more accessible in NZQA and making them credits. Because I know that you can get credits from working, but it's just not knowledge that's made known to our students.
And in fact, we had a discussion on breakfast yesterday about a greater sort of academic rigour. So yeah. Less of what you're saying and more of a kind of old-fashioned sense of education. You know, we talked during lockdown about students being able to Zoom in, right? Mm. Being able to go to school from home. Mm. But that presupposes unlimited broadband access. Yeah. It presupposes every kid has a device. Yeah. Is that the reality of the households and the families you know?
No. I think that a lot of schools are really working hard to make sure that that's something that can be tangible and put in front of students before the end of the year. And there have been so many charities and non-government organisations that step forward to kind of make this accessible.
Should they have to do that?
No, I don't think so. I don't think it's on people who have already been struggling to go out of their way to make sure that it is more accessible for our community. But I know that it's all done out of love. So that is something that I see a lot.
And I know you're not ungrateful.
Yes.
But what you're saying is there is a larger systemic failure here. Mm. And charity addressing it and us saying, we hear you, Feely, isn't the solution. Mm. So what is your message to our politicians a week and a half out from the election? And you put that question to Judith Collins and Jacinda Ardern in the first debate. And I don't want to put words in your mouth, but I think you were a little bit underwhelmed by their response, weren't you?
Yes, unfortunately. I think that long-term solutions are great, but Aotearoa teens graduate in 2 months. And I think they need to know that our students are looking to them for reassurance, for hope, like what was mentioned in that leaders' debate, hope is needed. But the answers that we got were very hopeful. They weren't really focused on the students of now, or what they're going through right now and what they need to see before the end of the year. So I would say to politicians, it's great to have these conversations, but I think we need to acknowledge that those conversations needed to have been started a lot longer ago than they have been right now.
And also, at some point, they have to stop being conversations and there has to start being meaningful action, right?
Yeah. I think a lot of our students are just waiting for real answers, I would say, real tangible solutions that they see themselves reflected in and not tokens, not as tokens, yeah.
So you talk about people finishing year 13, and if you are watching this, if you are a year 13 student or a mum or a dad at home and you are watching this in a wealthy household, you're possibly having conversations about what university you're going to go to. Will it be Otago? Will it be Vic? Will it be Auckland? Are all the kids that you know and love who are absolutely capable of going to university going to be able to go to university? Do they have the same choices?
No. And I say no because I know that a lot of students have so much limitless potential, but they have been put limitations because of the circumstances that they can't change. And so I know that a lot of our students, students that I've talked to and met throughout the course of this year, are going to be going to work because they feel like there's no other option, because they feel like they haven't been heard enough, that the solutions seem like they can rely on them. And so I know that a lot of our students are actually going to be taking up that mantle of providing for their families, even though they would like to go into tertiary study. Yeah, I think that's very much the reality for a lot of the students that we have.
It's a tough reality, isn't it? Yeah. To not have the same choice as other children. Sorry, I'm not calling you a child. As other year 13 students, yeah. It's a tough reality, isn't it, Feely?
Yeah.
Thank you for blowing the whistle. Mm-hmm. And thank you for not giving up. And thank you for not taking, you know, people in positions of authority saying, we hear you, Feely, as being good enough. Because by demanding change, you will effectively create, eventually, an environment where change has to happen or we shame ourselves, right? That's your point, Feely. And also, I know you want me to tell people it's not about you, that there are lots of brilliant young men and women like you.
Yes. I'm literally not even the tip of the iceberg.
It's just you had the Insta account, we noticed, Feely. Aigagalefili Fepulea'i Tapua'I. Thank you so much
for
coming
in.
I'm so proud of you.
Thank you.
And the work you do. You are a remarkable young person.
Yeah.